Construction crew accidentally ruptured a high-pressure natural gas line this morning in Seneca.
That meant evacuations and the shutdown of Highway 130 for hours. News 4's Angela Rodriguez joins us live and local. She is in Seneca tonight. Angela, these natural gas lines are usually marked off. How did this happen?
Well, this one was marked off, Michael. Construction crews told officials they just plain forgot the line was there. The danger was over long ago, but it has taken 8 hours to get this neighborhood back to normal.
Just before 10 this morning, neighbors along Highway 130 noticed a strange smell.
A bad odor, like rotten eggs, something. It made me sick and nauseated.
Officials say Tougaloo Pipeline Incorporated was installing a sewer line when a backhoe ruptured a high-pressure natural gas line.
You're talking about a lot of pressure with a dangerous gas.
The immediate area was evacuated. Some 20 families were affected. Fort Hill Natural Gas says the line was clearly marked.
The operator that actually hit it acknowledged the fact that he knew it was there, but because of rain yesterday, he didn't get to work here. He came back and forgot that the gas line was there. That's what he had told us. So it's purely accidental.
Because the gas is so volatile, before crews could begin repairs, they had to wait for hours to let the residual pressure bleed out. We're told crews will work through the night to restore service to the 100 to 300 customers still being affected. And officials still don't know how much gas leaked. Seneca fire crews say it shot straight up into the sky and dissipated.
We're very blessed nothing happened.
The threat is over, but those who live in the area may need some more time to forgive.
But my whole house got filled up with it bad. I still got a headache from it. Why did they see all these gas things in the yard? How could they forget?
You can bet that question will be asked over and over again. The gas company tells us that the company responsible will be getting a bill for all of this, one that will likely be tens of thousands of dollars. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, live in Seneca.